And good morning, my classmates. My team asked the room, which is?
I'm Calvin.
I'm Simone.
I'm Teddy.
I'm here.
And I, Vanessa, are here to persuade you people to agree with us that background checks should be mandatory in hiring. Which my teammate and I strongly believe that the lack of background checks could bring many major difficulties and issues for the businesses. So, through our research, I like to start with the information that I think is very compelling and kind of scary. The thefts and other forms of employee crimes are responsible for an estimate of 30% for all business failures. So I went after Kevin Connell, a very educated and knowledgeable businessman who does background check for many business in the whole United States. And he based his information in academic resources and also his own 15 years of experience. And he let us know that 1/3 of the job applications are falsified. 43%, close to half, of job applications that they screen in that business has some kind of falsification. And he also added that the top 5 resume lies is related to date of employment, job title, criminal records, inflated salary, education. So I like to tell you, and me too, when I was doing this work, that as business students, and most like future business people, I believe that none of us would like to hire somebody who started to misleading us since the beginning. So briefly, I'm gonna show you a video from Kevin Connell explaining why today more and more businesses are doing just two main reasons. Doing a background check in the employees before they hire them.
Some resumes, or they just want to see whether this person is a sort of a stand-up person and is going to be a good employee in their company.
Yeah, great question, Dalja. They do it for mainly two reasons. One is for business reasons. They want to make sure that they're hiring the right person for the right job to satisfy the business need. And then the second reason that they do it is for legal reasons. Companies can be exposed to negligent hiring lawsuits. So if you hire somebody and you don't do a background check and it comes back that they injure or harm a coworker or the general public, they can be sued under the legal doctrine of negligent hiring. And some of those lawsuits can get into the millions of
dollars.
So to finalize my part here, I want to give you two more information that from our resource, everybody knows about OSHA. According to them, 2 million American workers have been victims of workplace violence each year, which I think is a huge number. No matter how many employees we have in the United States, 2 million is so many people to be hurt. And according to the Labor Department of Federal Occupation Injuries, homicide is the third leading cause of occupation death for our workers, exceed only vehicular incidents and falls. So my teammate Ted is going to continue compel you guys to understand the importance of our talk. Thank you for
your attention. Thank you, Anise. Great job. So I'm going to talk about why we need background checks. And unfortunately, not everyone is who they say they are. And I'm going to have examples after the slide. And they're going to be kind of dark, so bear with me, but I'm going to show examples of why you can't lie on that, why you need to always check. And this uncertainty can cost the employer both money and reputation. There's experts out there that guess that the rehire after bad hire could cost up to five times the original hire. And but the problem is, a lot of small business, say you're starting a small restaurant or something, and these background checks, they aren't free. They cost money. And let's say you're going to New York, a criminal check in New York is going to cost you $75. But I'm going to try to argue here that this $75, $125, whatever state you're in, it could save your company up to $1,000. All right. So does anyone recognize these two photos? I mean, this guy could be a professor. Maybe it's a young daughter here. Anyone recognize these two? Anybody? Donut, you can't answer. You already know. So this guy on the left, he's Osama bin Laden. I think we know who he is, unfortunately. And then this is Aline Wuornos. And she was a prostitute in California who was a serial killer. And she would claim her clients were raping her, and then she murdered them. Eventually, she was caught. So obviously, appearances are deceiving. All right, so here's Jason Dalton. He was from California. He was an Uber driver. And he passed their standard regular background check. Unfortunately, his mental history was not checked, which it should have been. He went on a shooting spree and killed six people. And he was quoted as saying he was being controlled by the devil on the Uber app. So obviously we need more than just a simple background check. All right, so believe it or not, this is actually the same guy here. This is Nathan Osborne. In between those pictures right in the middle, he was actually hired at McDonald's. He had quite the eventful summer. So on June 23rd, he was spotted on the side of the highway. He was stopped by a cop. It's obviously not legal walking the side of the highway. He had a knife. He had to be tasered twice, so he went on probation for that. And then on September 6th, I think, he was hired at McDonald's in Chillicothe, Missouri. And after being hired, by October 9th, he had stabbed his manager and charged with first-degree assault. So obviously, as you can see by that, you need more. You need to look into the criminal background. McDonald's doesn't check criminal backgrounds in some states, and Missouri, they really should. So I'm going to pass it off to my great friend Calvin here, who's going to talk about some solutions.
All right, thank you, Teddy. So I'm Calvin. I'm going to be discussing about the solution and how to satisfy and end this kind of issue. Unfortunately, mass shootings and domestic terrorism have become commonplace in our reality. It's something that's happening globally and something at the home front. So we need to ensure different ways to prevent tragedies before they can even happen. So we had an overview of why we need background checks to ensure the general safety of the general public and the workplace. Next slide, please. So it talks about how we're trying to prevent negligent hiring and for security. So this visual, it shows that only certain amounts of information is displayed on the common background check. So employers, depending on what the position is, like suppose you were being hired into the federal government, of course they're gonna do the highest level background check that they can, and it will even do a psych evaluation. However, most positions in like a mom and pop shop or local businesses do not do psych evals or even look into further criminal history. So, next slide, please. So we think that the solution to ending workplace violence and increasing safety for the general public would be have mandated background checks for all hiring processes, as well as increasing how in-depth we go with these background checks. So it's just, as I said, to protect the general safety. And if you do fail a background check, we're not trying to ostracize you or like discriminate against you. We're trying to, if you do fail the background checks and you come up as like you have a mental illness, we can offer you aid. Like, get the help that you need before you harm others and harm yourself. So right now, the current legislation is the Civil Rights Act of 1964. And one of the titles specifically prohibits employers from discrimination based on criminal record, race, or national origin. Next slide, please. So what we propose is maybe going, talking to your legislators and perhaps amending it. But first off, as I said, raise awareness. So mental illness is a growing issue in the United States. So we're gonna try to do more required screenings and mental evaluations and check for violent tendencies or serious offenses in your criminal history. Because certain employers are only allowed to look back at a certain amount of time. It's almost like there's a statute of limitations on certain crimes that show up on your record. So as I said, we're not like trying to ostracize or like distinguish between certain people and treat them differently. we're not trying to discriminate. So there are programs that we can suggest for ex-convicts who do want to be hired, such as prisoner fellowship that helps them readjust into society and find a payable job. And if you do have a criminal history and you want to be hired, we suggest like perhaps making a new process where you can have a sponsor or a mentor that can show your rehabilitation. Next, please. So as I said, maybe you could start a petition online, get signatures, email your senators and legislators to try to raise more awareness for this issue. And all in all, maybe even have the government regulate prices on background checks by third-party organizations like AccuScreen and higher right organizations.
There have been many cases where background checks were not made and resulted in violent and nonviolent crimes, as well as theft, sexual assault. The annual cost to American employer is about $40 billion. It costs a company with theft. They have also been told that they're falsifying time cards and abusing sick leave and drug use. According to most recent figures of the Justice Department Bureau of Statistics, workplace violence between 1993 and 2009, as many as 572,000 non-fatal crimes occurred in the workplace in a single year. The figures are staggering. Consider a majority of the victims whose assailants were other employees and acquaintances. These cases could have been avoided if there were proper procedures taken and proper background checks. I know my company, when I got my job, they had to dig very deep for my background check because I do work for the government. And it took them about 4 weeks to come back with my return. And it has helped out a lot. And I'm gonna pass it on to Simone.
As Manisa said, even if people moderate, they may be the one who will hurt you. So that background checks cannot be ignored. Teddy, because background checks cost a certain amount of expenditure, but it is worth covering med supplements because it prevents and reduces crimes and try offer eyes to those people who need to be treated. Next please. So right now we need to actually do something. First of all, if any of your work is an employer or as a human resources department, you should remind yourself that firstly, checking employers' background is significant because, as Monita said, background checks can protect organization and your reputation from company. It also can protect employees and customers. Moreover, Teddy said background checks, without background checks, can cost employers extra money. Secondly, you should do the careful investigation, like screen for criminal record and credit check for position involving accounting or financial responsibility and alcohol and drug tests. Furthermore, you can get together to... secondly, you should do the, to minimize the hidden dangers such as theft, violence, murder caused by mental illness and violence choices to avoid discrimination in the results based on race, national origin, sex, religion, disability, genetic information, and age. Furthermore, we can get together to take initiative online and sign the petition to the Congress to advocate the government to popularize and develop the bill to mandatory background checks in Heron. These are the actions we can take to mandatory background checks in Heron.
All right, that's good. Anybody have any questions for us? I know we're a little late here.